Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi ta'ala wabarakatuh. Professor Walid, former rectors, former deputy rectors, former dean, former lecturers, colleagues, brothers and sisters. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alamin. Wassalatu wassalam wa syafil anbiya mursalin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. I hope you can hear me well and clear without any echoes. Yeah. Let me first of all thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for giving me this opportunity to give you a few words on this very timely and very imaginative meeting of the minds to talk about the former rector who have been instrumental in building up the university. I would like to state at the offset that I'm here actually to learn about the university, to learn about what has been done by the former rectors, and every morning as I walk into my office, I'm greeted by all the former rectors. There are their pictures on the hall that I am reminded that I'm the sixth rector and I have to carry on the difficult legacy of moving the university forward, given the many things that have been done making the university what it is. So I humbly submit that I'm here to learn, and particularly so when I do not have what Professor Walid said, the personal context with Professor Emeritus Dato' Dr. Abdul Hamid Abu Sulaiman. I have the very unfortunate circumstances not meeting him in person, but then I have read his books. I have talked to people about him, and I have heard the many things that he represented as far as the university is concerned. For sure, I think the professor is a visionary. He has instructed many things to make what the university as it is. And I'm told he's a very hands-on person who also work not only from his office, but also walk about the university to make sure that the university is what it is intended for. Yeah, he's a great scholar. He has also ideas of what university ought to be moving forward. And these are the things that we are guided and inspired by. And I do hope the discussion will enlighten me a little bit more so that we can follow his footsteps and moving forward, right? I have the honor of taking this rectorship from the former rector. At a junction, I thought it is kind of critical when we talk about the pandemic. If there's any rector would differentiate me from the previous rector is the pandemic. I have this privilege of handling this pandemic, even in my long career in the university. This is a great challenge for us. And yet, I think the inspiration of handling this case comes from many of the works that have been done before. How do you get together? How do you move the university together? How do you represent the university as a university with a heart, as a university with a soul, as a university that actually cares for fellow human beings? And that was tested, I think, during the 2 years I'm here. And I'm indeed very happy that these values are still very much alive. But yet, when we talk about the post-pandemic, I think the challenge is bigger than that. What sort of future do we envisage? And what sort of curriculum, what sort of pedagogy, what sort of structure, what sort of attitude do we need to put in place, not forgetting what has been built, but what are the new demands ahead? And this is where I think this discussion today to me is something which is very important. And I once again would say that I am here to learn, and I really want to listen very closely to what you have said, so that many of the things that we have gathered tonight will perhaps be instrumental also in harnessing the plans that we have created for ourselves to move the university forward. Just to briefly mention, I think the university has decided on the future to move forward, given some of the imperatives that we've got. And I think this is not the end of the story. The university will be discussing about this until the end of January. before we decide what will be the shape of the university. And certainly your input tonight is something that we welcome, coming from your experience, coming from the kind of knowledge that you've got, and also the various situation you are in different countries will probably make a lot more difference from what we have gathered in the university for the last 2 years or so. So on that note, let me thank Professor Walid for having this vision and courage to talk about the past, given the contribution of the directors. And I certainly hope we will also revisit the first rector. And of course, the third rector is with us all the time, Professor Kamal Hassan. We have been listening and, you know, getting advice from him. And then we have the fourth and the fifth rector. So this is a long journey, Prof. Walid, but certainly a significant one. And I hope we will do this in the best way we could. So on that note, let me wish you well, a very fruitful deliberation. And hopefully we will gather again at some point to talk about what's next as far as the university is concerned. So I thank all of you for your time, and I thank for you all the efforts that have been taken to still connect with the university. Certainly the university needs your support, needs your input, and of course need your advice as we go along. So on that note, wabillahi taufiq wa hidayah, assalamualaikum warahmatullahi ta'ala wabarakatuh, and thank you very much.